Hearing loss is something that affects a lot more people than you might think, with some 15% of the population experiencing some degree of hearing loss. And for the gig lovers among you, tinnitus can be a real problem. I'm joined in studio by GP Dr. Nina Burns, who's going to talk to us about all of this. Nina, you're very welcome to the programme.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
Now, the problem about hearing loss is that people don't always know they have hearing loss. They're just missing a lot of stuff that's going on around them. And it takes others maybe to point it out that they are not paying attention.
Exactly. In the majority of cases, it is a friend or a family member who will say it. Because as you said, if you're listening to the TV really loud and you have a hearing deficit, you clearly don't realise that you're listening to the TV really loud. And it's only when other people walk in the room and sort of, you know, pick up the remote and turn it down. And in fact, recently I was talking to a gentleman who had hearing loss and said, you know, it's his daughter walked into the house and sort of covered her ears and said, what are you doing? And turned the level down to where she felt it was reasonable and he couldn't hear it at all. And that's when he realised that clearly there was a problem.
Now, it is age-related as well, isn't it? In the natural course of things, never mind any damage you might have done to yourself.
Well, there is a certain amount of age-related hearing loss, but, you know, we are seeing it younger and younger because we are exposed to higher levels of noise in our lives. And obviously, there are lots of other things that can damage your hearing. So I think, although you're right, in the majority of cases, there is a certain amount of age-related loss. And in the majority of people over 65, you know, a large proportion of those, I should say, would have some hearing deficit. It is really important to stress that this is not just a problem of older people, and it's a message we feel very strongly about getting out there.
How much of it is genetic?
How much of it is genetic? Well, it's not.
I mean, people,
well, obviously,
you know, daddy was deaf and now daughter is deaf.
Okay, so when we're talking about deafness, it's very different to hearing loss, say. So there are deafness, you know, deafness can run in families, but the majority of sort of the hearing loss you get with age wouldn't necessarily be a genetic component. So it would be more down to maybe your occupational exposure in life, other illnesses you've had. Years ago, some of the drugs used for TB and things like that could damage your hearing. So there's a cumulative effect. And, you know, lifestyle, we now know that a lot of the risks for dementia, you know, certain things that increase cardiovascular risk can also affect your hearing. Remember, there's a blood supply to the important parts of your ear. So just recently I was reading a report on dementia and lifestyle, and one of the things that they listed as an important way of reducing your chance of dementia is to look after your hearing.
And it seems that they, you know, it's unlikely they're related, but they are.
Well, because we know that, say, for dementia, it's important to remain engaged, to keep the brain active. And unfortunately, a lot of people who have hearing loss, they're so embarrassed by it, they can't listen in a group of people. They start to withdraw socially. And we know that withdrawing socially is not good for you physically or mentally.
Now, this business of age, you know, there was an idea that when you had teenagers hanging out outside the shop, they played certain frequencies over speakers, which didn't perturb the middle-aged and older people going in to buy their groceries, but for some reason it really annoyed the teenagers, so they moved on.
Yeah.
So there is a natural thing, isn't there, about certain frequencies that the young can hear and the older people cannot.
There's a certain amount of frequency loss when you get older, and quite often you'll notice if you look at a hearing test of an older person that they've lost in the higher frequencies. But you know, speech is not in the particularly higher frequencies, but it is really important for clarity in that you're hearing a wide range of frequencies. You know, we know that dogs hear sounds that we don't hear, so we don't all need to hear those really, really high-pitched tones, but we do need to be able to understand and to operate in society.
Now, tinnitus is something that many people experience. Some can actually point to their occupation, maybe Kango hammers or sitting in front of the trumpets in a brass band or whatever it might be, or going to gigs where you're often not aware of the volume you're being subjected to until you leave the gig and you've got this ringing in your ears.
I'm sure there were many people walked away from you too at the weekend,
yeah,
you know, with tinnitus. And look, you know, there's sort of transient tinnitus, which is related to exposure to a noise. And if that's only happening, you know, if you only go to a concert every few years or something, you're not going to damage too much. But if you are repeatedly exposed to these high levels of noise, if you are repeatedly experiencing tinnitus, it's something to really watch. Because first of all, tinnitus can be very frustrating if it's there all the time. You know, some people are very aware of it. Some people cope quite well. They only notice it when they're lying in a quiet room on their own. But if it is something that you're experiencing regularly, if you are regularly listening to music or going to gigs or going places where you walk away and your ears are ringing, you need to be careful. That is your ears telling you you've damaged them.
Yeah, and there are, when you have tinnitus, then there are triggers which can make it worse.
For some people, there are. So some people, classically with migraines, some people will get an increased ringing in their ears before migraine. Or some people, if they have colds or flus, it gets a lot worse. So there are triggers that make it worse. And then in some people, it's just there at a background. But as I said, when they're in a more silent space, they're much more aware of it. And hearing aids can mask that noise. It does help with some people who have severe tinnitus.
Are there treatments for tinnitus?
Well, as I said, hearing aids can help in some people. Certainly, if there's an underlying issue with your ear, so if you have, you know, sort of some people, if they're very congested in their head, they'll hear a ringing or a noise in their ears. So it's always important to rule out any medically treatable condition. But unfortunately, it is a difficult thing to treat in many people.
Now, tell me about Hidden Heroes. What's that all about?
Hidden Heroes is an initiative that I love being involved with. So it is an awards ceremony that is sponsored by Hidden Hearing. And really, it's looking for heroes in your community. And I love this because it's looking for people who have done things that are important to their local group. It could be their family, it could be their sports club, it could be their town, it could be the community in which they live.
But are they supposed to be people with hearing loss, the heroes?
Not at all. These are not. No, there is a category in there for people with hearing deficit, but actually no. So this is not purely for people with hearing issues. This is for everybody and anybody. And we'd like all the towns and communities around Ireland to get behind it. We've had some wonderful nominations over the years. And so if there's someone who has made a difference in your life or in your community and you think they deserve to be recognised, please apply. You can go to hiddenhearing.ie or you can go into any Hidden Hearing branch.
Okay, and the closing day for nominations is Sunday, the 6th of August. And Dr. Nina Burns, thank you very much for joining us in the studio. Now, coming up next, more than 600 people are on the waiting list to buy one of 41 affordable cooperative houses in Ballymun. We'll be talking to the CEO of O'Coolan Co-Housing Alliance.